of unit cell, types of unit cell. This classification is based on the arrangement of atoms, ions or molecules. Okay, classification, this classification is based on arrangement of atoms, ions or molecules. Mainly we have two types. The first one is primitive unit cell. Primitive, or we also call it as simple unit cell. Primitive or simple unit cell. The second type we have centered unit cell. Centered unit cell. See, the first part of this chapter, like I said, all those concepts of void, unit cell, geometry and all, this conceptual. Okay, you have to imagine the structure also. I'll make you understand. But if you think like you can memorize simply and do the questions, it's very difficult. Okay, the concept you have to understand, that is in the first part of the chapter. Second part you have to memorize. Okay, so for reference we'll take this classroom to understand the structure of the what we say, the crystal that we'll discuss. Okay, centered unit cell further classified into three categories. Okay, the first one is BCC, body centered cubic unit cell. BCC is body-centered cubic unit cell, FCC is face-centered cubic unit cell, and end-centered cubic unit cell, ECC, end-centered cubic unit cell. The most important one for this chapter is FCC. FCC is the most important one. We'll tell you. BCC, then the next important, okay. End-centered is not that much important, okay. End-centered cubic unit cell. End-centered cubic unit cell. Okay, one by one we'll discuss this. See, I have written BCC, body-centered cubic unit cell. Cubic unit cell means unit cell is a cube. Okay, so you can draw a unit cell like this. We'll have hexagonal unit cell also possible. And when we say hexagonal unit cell, it is a hexagon, okay, not a cube. So you'll have a cube like this, right? Unit cell is this, okay. Now, like I said, unit cell is this. Now, when this unit cell you repeat in three dimensional, or in all these three directions, okay, you'll generate the entire crystal lattice. It's like a matchbox, 1000 matchbox. If you arrange side by side, top and bottom, you'll get the entire lattice. Okay, yeah, if you have this what we say, any structure, suppose if you have an entire structure like diamond, what is the basic structure of a diamond? Tetrahedral, right? You'll have an arrangement of tetrahedral carbon, four carbons are attached. Now this four carbon, the tetrahedral arrangement, is actually there in the, if you arrange this pattern in three dimensional space, you'll get the entire structure of what? Diamond. Okay, now when you take this particular structure out, now what we say, we have a repeating unit of tetrahedral carbon chain in diamond structure. If you want to study the property of diamond, you take the unit cell out, you study the property of this, that will be the property of the entire crystal. Okay, so crystal is made up of a basic repetitive unit, and that basic repetitive unit is what? Unit cell. Got it? So mainly we'll discuss about cubic unit cell. Okay, that is the most important one. Hexagonal also possible, only one thing is there, we'll discuss that. Okay, but we'll have this one only in the chapter, cubic unit cell. Now in this cubic unit cell, like I said, what is a lattice point? Lattice point is what? Where the atoms, molecules or ions are placed. Okay, so here you see, if I place the atom only at the corner, these are the corners. How many corners are there in a cube?
Eight
corners, right? If atoms are placed only at the corner, don't draw this, just listen to me. We'll do this one by one. So these are the lattice points, okay? There are eight corners. So lattice points are this when the atoms are placed here, okay? Now in a cube, we'll have eight corners. How many faces?
Six.
Six faces, you should know this. Eight corners, six faces. How many edges are there? 12 edges, right? Six faces, so we'll have six face center also, 12 edges and 12 edge center also. So when the atoms are placed only at the corners, then it is simple unit cell or primitive unit cell. Correct? This is one thing. In center unit cell is what? Apart from the atoms at the corner, the atoms are placed at other position also into the unit cell. Like if you want to define this BCC, we'll have atoms at the corner and atoms at the body center. That's why it is body centered cubic unit cell. Corner pe to hoga hi, corner se hata nahi sakte. BCC if you want to define, along apart from this atoms at the corner, one atom at the body center. Body center means, suppose this is a cube, right? So we'll have atoms at all corners, four corners on the top, four corners on the bottom, right? So we'll have atoms here also at the body center. This is body center unit cell, okay? Face center is what? We'll have atoms at the corner along with the atoms at the face center, right? So this is one face center, another face center is this, this face center, this face, and all the face center, right? So when the atoms are placed at all face center, it is known as face centered cubic unit cell, okay? In the center means what? Atoms at the corner plus atoms at the opposite face. Any two opposite face, like this center and this center, or this center and this center, or this center and this center. This is your front one. This is the center of this center. Okay? There are three different unit cell. We have centered unit cell, correct? We'll discuss this, like there are many things we have to find out into this. Like suppose if I ask you, what is the effective number of atoms present in primitive unit cell?
2.
Primitive unit cell.
What is the
one? Effective number of atoms means what? In a unit cell, how many atoms are present?
1.
Okay?
It's not
one. See, actually you see, 2. Wait. Primitive unit cell, what did I ask you? How many atoms are present within the unit cell?
Effective.
Right?
Effective.
So effective unit to find out. So when the atoms are at this corner, okay, the entire atoms is not within the unit cell. Suppose you have corner pe ek atom ko rakha. Okay? So there are many, like the most part of the atoms is outside the unit cell. Corner pe jo atom hai, the most part of that atom is outside the unit cell. So we have to count only that part which is within the unit cell. So you tell me one thing, with this corner, see when you do this question in the exam, jahan pe baithe ho examination hall ko, see ko cube maan le. And sada kuch bhi imagine karna. It'll be easy for you to do that. Okay? Now suppose the atoms are present at that corner. Okay? Now how many cubes you can draw from that corner? How many cubes you can draw? Only one. Why? A cube ye ho gaya. Iske piche ek hoga.
So
4. 4 to is plane mein, thoda upar bhi hoga. Samajh rahe ho baat? 1 cube here, iske piche ek aur iske piche. So 4 in this plane and 4 on the top also. So when you take this entire 8 cubes, this will be the center of that cube. So samajh rahe ho baat? Right? It means what? The atoms present at this corner is distributed in among 8 cubes, right? That's why the contribution in 1 cube is
one.
So here if I ask you, what is the effective number of the atoms? 8 corners and the contribution of 1 corner is 1 by 8. So 8 into 1 by 8 is 1. Okay? So we have to do all these calculations. Correct separately in primitive BCC and FCC. But you should know the contribution. Corner to get contribution, face center to get contribution, like this you have to imagine. Okay? But there are one thing which we'll discuss before this write down. There are, next slide, there are 7 primitive unit cell. There are 7 primitive unit cell possible. There are 7 primitive unit cell possible and their variations are as follows. So I'll draw this table. Okay, on this table they have asked question once. Okay, this all these possible variations we call it as Brevius lattice. Okay, so they have asked how many various Brevius lattice is possible. I'll write down here. So I'll draw the table, you copy it down. This you have to memorize. The first column I'll write down here. crystal lattice. Crystal lattice. Then the possible variations. Edge length. Edge length, axial distance, also we call it as, and axial angles. Axial angles. Okay, so we are taking the reference of this. This is x, y, and z. Edge length on x axis is a. And opposite angle is alpha. Okay, it is B and this is beta, this is C and this is gamma. This also is from beta because we'll have to take the reference of this, so we'll take this as C, this is gamma, and this is B, this is beta. Because actually, what happens, we'll draw this table with reference of this. If you change this A, B, and C, the entire thing will change. Okay? So copy it on as it is. The length on y axis is C, and at opposite angle is gamma. Z axis is B, beta, A, and alpha. Okay? So the first crystal lattice we write down, we have cubic crystal lattice. Okay? The first one is cubic. Now in cubic, the different possible variations are, we can have primitive unit cell. Primitive unit cell, I'll write it as PRM for reference. Okay, primitive unit cell. And we can have body centered BC, or we can have face centered. Only these three possible variations we have. What is the edge length for cubic? Cube hai to A is equals to B is equals to C. You sakta hai, right? And what is the axial angles? All three angles are 90. Alpha, beta, gamma, 90. Okay, this is the first thing. Now, the next one is tetragonal. Tetragonal, the possible variations is primitive, PRM, and body center. Only two possible variations we have. Okay, primitive and body center. The edge length is A is equals to B, does not equals to C, and the angle is, all three angles are equal to 90 degrees. Tetragonal. The next one is orthorhombic. Orthorhombic, all four possible variations are there. Primitive possible, body centered possible, face center possible, end center possible. All four possible variations we have. And here the three edges are different. A does not equals to B, does not equals to C, but the angles are still 90 degrees. Okay, the next one is hexagonal. Hexagonal, we have only one variations we have, that is primitive. Okay, only one variations. And then the edge length is A equals to B, does not equals to C. Alpha beta is 90. But gamma is 120. Rhombohedral. Or we also call it as trigonal. Rhombohedral or trigonal. In this only we have one possible variations, that is primitive, A is equals to B is equals to C, alpha is equals to beta is equals to gamma, but it is not equal to 90 degree. Okay, monoclinic, the second last one, monoclinic, two possible variations, primitive and end center. A does not equals to B, does not equals to C. Alpha, gamma is 90. and beta is not equal to 90. The last one is triclinic. The only possible is variation is primitive. A does not equals to B, does not equals to C. Alpha does not equals to beta, does not equals to gamma, does not equals to. These are the possible variations. Okay. Now you see, I have given this in a pattern. If you remember this, you can write down this easily. First one, all three are equal. Last one is not equal, all three are different. Then reverse. The last one is not equal, all three are equal, and for the last two, none of them are equal. A does not equal to B, does not equal to C. Because they'll ask this, they'll give you for orthorhombic, rhombic, what is the, this, like this, they've given four options. We need to choose this, okay? Bahut bar exam mein ye question aaya, many times. This year also you'll get this question in any other time, okay? BITSAT, Manipal, whatever exam you write, CET, JEE mein, mostly it's not, it won't come, most probably because very straightforward now. Okay, but in other exam you definitely get this. Okay, NCRT may be DIY, all these things. You have to memorize this edge length and axial angles. Okay, so it is in an order. I will suggest you to memorize this and then you can write on this. For also, first three, all three angles are equal to 90 degree. Gamma is 120, not equal to 90 and 120. Okay, now the possible variation, like I said, 3 here, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 4, 9, 10, then 11, 13, and 14. That's why we have 14 previous factors possible. Okay, that's what this question also asked me. How many possible variations or various factors is possible? That is 14. The answer is. Got it? Okay, and all these edge length and axial angles based on this. X axis pe we have A, Y pe C, and B, Z pe B. A ke opposite alpha, B ke opposite beta, C ke opposite gamma. Okay? If they change this in the exam, if they give you this axis also, and if they change this A here, C here, B here, like that, the entire thing will change. Okay? So that's why it is important.